the number one brain hack to get better sleep. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh. In this video, let's talk about why you can't sleep, what's going on in your brain, and finally, number three, what can you do to sleep better? All right, so let's start with number one. Why can't you sleep? Sleep can be such a tricky thing when your brain is in a dysregulated brain performance pattern. We're gonna get to that in a minute. But long story short, there are two types of people in this world. The people who are primarily stuck in hyperarousal. Hyperarousal means you are in a go, go, go. You think a lot. It's very difficult for you to sit still. Your system is on. That type of person is using a brain that is going much too fast. So to be able to engage the sleep cycle and to stay in it, your brain has to slow all the way down to the very slowest speed. So if you're stuck in the fastest speed, the gap between where you are at bedtime and where you need to be is too big for you to fall asleep or stay asleep. Now, I already hear you, what you're saying. I fall asleep, no problem, but I wake up a couple hours later. That is because you are exhausted. That is a symptom of adrenal fatigue, which again comes out of a brain that is constantly on and never gets a break. And you know what I always say, where the problem is, the solution is. And we'll talk about that in just a minute. But if you're a person who's stuck in hyperarousal, like I used to be, the solution is to come out of hyperarousal and give your brain a break. Again, we'll get to it in a minute. Let's go to person number two. Person number two is that is stuck in a hypoarousal state. So if it's difficult for you to get off the couch, if you are stuck in neutral and you're unmotivated and you spend a lot of time on your phone or consuming passive media, you are stuck in hypoarousal. Your system is going much too slow. And again, a system that's going much too slow all day long, it's difficult for that nervous system to engage the sleep cycle also. To be able to engage the sleep cycle, you want to be able to be in the green zone during the day, that of calm focus, where your brain and your body and your mind are cycling through what are called circadian rhythms. It's kind of like shifting gears automatically all day long, so that at the end of the day, you're feeling groggy and tired, you're able to get into bed and relax. It takes 20 minutes to fall asleep, you engage the sleep cycle, and you get a beautiful night's sleep. So if you are stuck in hyperarousal or hypoarousal, or even if you're stuck in both of them simultaneously, which I call strained brain, this will make it very difficult for you to get a good night's sleep. So let's go to number two. What's going on in the brain? I've already alluded to it, but if you're a hypoarousal person, your brain is stuck in what is called high beta. High beta is the fastest brain speed that's associated with stress, anxiety, vigilance, hypervigilance, go, 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 think mode, get a lot done, productivity. High beta doesn't necessarily have to feel bad to you, but it is bad for you. So if you're stuck in this go, go, go mode, you will have difficulty slowing down enough to fall asleep. On the other side of the continuum are the people who are stuck in hypoarousal. Hypoarousal is called theta. Theta is the speed that basically is fall asleep mode. It contributes to attention issues. It's the biomarker underlying ADHD. It's associated with head injury. It makes you feel sleepy and groggy all day long. So if your brain is using too much high beta or too much theta or both of them simultaneously, it's difficult to fall asleep. And this is why. When you get in bed, it should take 20 minutes for your brain to come out of beta, which is slower than high beta. Beta and alpha, those medium speeds for calm focus, shift into theta so you're feeling groggy, and ultimately shift into delta, extra slow sleep mode. From Delta, your brain is able to cycle through speeding up and slowing down throughout the night, typically around 4 cycles for an individual. The cycles are not all created equally. What will happen over the course of the night is your brain is speeding up towards the morning when it's time to wake up. That's how your brain naturally wakes up if you don't set an alarm. But this is what happens if you're stuck in this hyper and hypo-aroused state, is that as you move through cycle 1, cycle 2, and your brain is becoming a little bit faster, now it will grab that high beta mode, or it will come out of that delta mode. And if that happens, then it's difficult for you to fall back asleep in the middle of the sleep cycle. So that is why being stuck in these different dysregulated brain patterns disrupts your sleep. Now, if you're following me, the dysregulated brain pattern in the daytime is what disrupts sleep at night. It's because your dysregulation at the brain level all day long makes it so you can't get into the sleep cycle. It's not necessarily a thing that's happening at night. It is a thing that's happening within the day. So let's go to number 3, your brain hack strategy for the day. What do you do about it? The solution is simple, but maybe not easy. It's to balance the way you are using your brain throughout the day. So what I mean by that is if you're a hyperarousal person, you need to create brain breaks in the day. You have to slow down. You have to turn your brain off and give it time to recover throughout the day, ideally every hour and a half. So for example, already today, I worked in my jammies for about an hour and a half. Then I cranked up some tunes, I made some breakfast, I ate while, yes, still dancing around in my jammies. Then I did a little bit more work for about another hour. Then I jumped in the shower. So I do this very intentionally to be able to be on, be off, be on, be off. That's what we're looking for. So if you're a person down on the other side of the spectrum in hypoarousal, you're mostly off. If you're on the couch a lot, what you have to do is get up, get your body moving, or get up and get into your head. A hyperarousal person has to come out of their head. A hypoaroused person could benefit from getting into their head and having some thoughts, get on purpose, have some intention, get moving, get your mind and body moving to come out of hypoarousal. So before I wrap up, discern if you're primarily hyperarousal or hypoarousal person, and which thing do you need to do? Do you need to create more brain breaks where you empty your mind out and come into your body and dance around in your jammies? Or are you a person who could benefit from getting on purpose and getting into your mind and thinking, getting into your body and moving? Yes, dancing around in your jammies. So if you are hyper or hypo-aroused, it's important to create that balance by doing one of those things that you are doing less of. This will make it so that when you get in bed, it will take 20 minutes to fall asleep while you're not thinking, you're letting that energy come down. And if you have a thought in the night, don't grab it. Focus on your breath in, out, so you can fall back asleep. Okay, I hope that helps you out. And if you're looking for more help on the journey of sleeping better, please go over to drtrishleigh.com. I have programs in all shapes and sizes to be able to help you do just that. Okay, until next time, control your brain or it'll control you.